For the first example, we're going to use closed captions in the CEA 608 standard. You can further edit and customize your captions in the Inspector panel in the top right section of Final Cut Pro. Make sure you select this icon. Make sure your caption clip is selected in the timeline. You can see all the individual caption fields in the caption panel. Here you can change the in and out time to move the captions, and in the caption text area, you can edit the caption text. You can change the style of your captions by using the options located at the top of the caption panel. An easy way to apply the style across all caption fields is to select them all. You can do this by selecting the first caption field and scrolling all the way to the bottom, and select the last caption field while holding down the shift key. Let's talk about the options available to modify the captions. You have three main categories: caption text, display, and timing. The first section is the section under the caption text, where you import your text and special characters. To the right of caption text, to the arrow pointing down, a drop-down box will appear and select which option you want. You have the option of adding any of these special characters. Another option in the drop-down menu is adding multiple text streams, which allows you to have captions on different positions of the screen at the same time. The second section is alignment. You can choose whether or not you want the captions to be aligned left, centered, or right. The next section is called placement. You can move around your captions to whatever location you would like. The first section under display is the display style, which is a drop-down list which offers you some options like pop-on, roll-up, and paint-on. These are typically for television broadcasting. By default, sites like YouTube use pop-on. Next is formatting. Here you can choose to italicize or to underline your text. Next is the text color, text background opacity, and the text background color. The last category is timing. This is where you can edit the start, end time, and duration for your caption. If you come up with a new style that you want to use for all of your captions for a project and future projects, you can save your style. Go to the right of display, and on the drop-down menu, select Save Style as Default. That will change the caption style to the new edited captions you have edited. For the second example, we will modify the SRT formatted captions. First, let's convert our captions from CEA 608 to SRT. Select one of the captions and press Command A. All of the captions in that format should be selected. Then right-click, and a drop-down menu should appear. Select Duplicate Captions in New Format, and then choose SRT. Your new captions will be on a new line below the CEA 608 standard. You can toggle between the different formats by going to the bottom left of Final Cut to the Timeline Index. Select Roles, and then toggle through which caption format you want to be active. Formatting SRT is similar to formatting in CEA 608 format. Your formatting options include making the text bold, italic, or underline, changing the color of the text, and editing the start, ending, and duration of the captions. Please note that broadcasting networks and sites like YouTube have pre-existing broadcasting standards to make sure captions are optimally delivered across all screen resolutions and formats in the closed caption format. In the next video, we'll cover how to export your captions from Final Cut Pro.